Defense Secretary Delfin Lorenzana confirms the COVID-19 vaccines used by members of the Presidential Security Group, or PSG, were smuggled, noting that the importation was unauthorized. But he claims the intention behind the act is justified, as it is meant to protect President Rodrigo Duterte. In an interview with ABS-CBN Wednesday, December 30, Lorenzana says that PSG should explain why it vaccinated its members ahead of the approval of the Food and Drug Administration, or the FDA. On the same day, PSG Chief Brigadier General Jesus Durante says he takes full responsibility for the unregistered vaccine administered on his men. In an interview on ANC's Head Start, Durante defends the PSG, saying it was necessary to ensure the president's security and they did the vaccination independently. Durante says some PSG members had been vaccinated against COVID-19 as early as September, while the last batch was done in October. The Bureau of Customs says on Tuesday, December 29, it was not informed of the importation of the COVID-19 vaccines given to the military personnel and top officials of the government. The agency says, if the vaccines are proven to be smuggled, officials involved could face administrative and civil cases. Justice Secretary Menardo Guevara says on Wednesday, December 30, he ordered the National Bureau of Investigation to investigate the illegally obtained vaccines in the Philippines. Chinese pharmaceutical Sinopharm announces Wednesday, December 30, its coronavirus vaccine is 79% effective in its Phase 3 trials. This is lower than rival vaccines developed by Pfizer, BioNTech, and Moderna, but a potential breakthrough in the battle to stem the pandemic in Asia. Beijing Institute of Biological Products says the protective effect of Sinopharm vaccine against COVID-19 is 79.34%. China is struggling to gain international trust for its vaccine candidates, hindered by a lack of transparency on test results. It has also been slow to complete Phase 3 trials, which had to be conducted abroad due to China's success at curbing the spread of COVID-19 within its own borders. Chinese officials have repeatedly assured the public of the vaccine's safety, claiming that there have been no serious adverse reactions. Filipinos should expect to pay higher member contributions to the Philippine Health Insurance Corporation, or PhilHealth, beginning next year. In a statement Tuesday, December 29, PhilHealth says it is implementing the scheduled contribution rate and adjustment in income ceiling for 2021. PhilHealth explains this is to ensure sufficient funding for the healthcare benefits of its 110 million members as mandated by Republic Act No. 11223 or the Universal Healthcare or UHC law. According to PhilHealth, starting in 2021, the monthly premium of those earning below 10,000 pesos per month is fixed at 350 pesos. Those earning more than 10,000 pesos to 69,999.99 pesos monthly will have a premium rate of 350 pesos to 2,449.99 pesos per month, while those earning 70,000 pesos or higher per month is fixed at 2,450 pesos. PhilHealth says that while it recognizes the pandemic situation is taking its toll on Filipinos, it is bound to implement the UHC law that aims for better healthcare services as the country grapples with COVID-19. PhilHealth was embroiled in a corruption scandal in 2020 when whistleblowers claimed some 15 billion pesos in funds were pocketed by executives. Meantime, the Social Security System, or SSS, will also have a contribution rate of 13% next year, 1% higher than the current rate. For employed members, the additional 1% will be divided equally between them and their employers. SSS President and CEO Aurora C. Ignacio says, while they understand the plight of covered employers and members, it is their duty to allow the continuous delivery of Social Security protection to their current and future members, as well as their beneficiaries. Reporters Without Borders, or RSF, says 50 journalists and media workers were killed in connection with their work in 2020. A majority of the journalists died in countries that are not at war. The figure shows an increase in the targeting of reporters investigating organized crime, corruption, or environmental issues. RSF says 84% of those killed this year were deliberately targeted for their work. This is higher than the 63% reported in 2019. RSF Editor-in-Chief Pauline Aides Mevel says investigative journalists are in the crosshairs of states or cartels. Among all countries, Mexico was the deadliest country, with 8 killed. The report says journalists who dare cover the links between drug traffickers and politicians continue to be the targets of barbaric murders. The other countries that are considered deadly for journalists are Iraq, Afghanistan, India, and Pakistan. The total number of journalists killed in 2020 was lower than the 53 reported in 2019, although RSF says fewer journalists worked in the field this year because of the COVID-19 pandemic. It also lists 387 jailed journalists, which it called a historically high number. Facebook page The Filipino Insider posts a photo claiming that Vice President Lenny Robredo gave money to the bereaved family of Sonia and Frank Gregorio, who were shot dead by an off-duty police officer on December 20. The claim is false. Reverse image search shows the photo was tweeted on December 22 by the Philippine Information Agency Regional Office 3. The DSWD gave financial aid to the Gregorio family during the visit of DSWD Undersecretary Aimee Torre-Franco Neri and DSWD Regional Director Marites Maristela. In a Facebook post, Robredo denies she is the woman in the photo, adding that while her office extended assistance to the Gregorio family, her staff never posted it.